So our Pierson Fixture Friday series highlights the best practices for building fixtures. But in this video, we're covering what not to do so your pallet fixtures don't suck. I was made for this. I was made for this. Okay, so we've shown you plenty of examples from our own production, as well as some really great examples from our customers. But let's talk about what not to do when designing a fixture into one of our pallets. Now, even if you're going against some of these points and disagree with me, it's really just a matter of time where some of these problems will pop up, and I want to spare you that grief. So starting off, we're all familiar with these style of rocker clamps, which in my opinion are the best choice for small clamps because not only do they have high clamping force for their size, but they also apply downward pressure, keeping your part flat and secure. So here's what not to do when using these. Number one, don't use the wrong size. Now, these come in sizes from 3/8 inch wide all the way up to 1.5 inch wide. So which one do you use? Well, I recommend starting with the 3/4 inch size. The 1/2 inch size is tempting because of their lower price and decent holding force. But for 50% wider of a clamp, you get nearly 2.5 times more holding force. That's why I say don't start with the 1/2 inch width, or eventually you might throw a part and wreck your day. Number two, don't create slots for these clamps to sit in. Now, I've seen examples from the manufacturers of these using slots, but in my suspicion, it's that these photos were originally taken with clamps and slots, just because in the days of manual machines, it was so much easier to create a slot than it was to create a nice machined pocket for the clamp to sit in. However, like I've said before, slots weaken your fixtures significantly, and a pocket leaves remaining material to strengthen it. For example, our Pro pallets off the shelf are 1.5 inch thick, but if you were to put a slot in it that's about 1/2 inch deep, you've essentially thinned out your pallet to only 1 inch thick. Now, if you have multiple rows and you tighten down all the clamps, the cumulative clamping force will absolutely bow the pallet and throw off your repeatability in Z. Pockets, not slots. Number three, don't get Mickey Mouse with your pockets. Now, what do I mean by this? Obviously, you can't create square corners with round end mills. So there has to be some type of radius in these pocket corners. Now, common practice is to put a relief a little bit larger than the diameter of the end mill. And that's where you get the name Mickey Mouse, just because of the appearance. Now, this is fine, but just make sure that this relief is not cutting into the backside support edge of the clamp. You want the entire width of that back edge supported. If it's not fully supported, it will prematurely deform and wear the back edge, and your clamp will not contact your part correctly. Even worse, the clamp will shift far enough from the part where you will get a false clamp against the opposite side of the pocket. Number four, don't use them for what they're not meant for. Now, what do I mean by this? Browsing online, I've come across fixtures that have clamps on opposite sides of the part. So why would we not do this? Well, think about it. These clamps are not secure edge stops, and they can float one way or another if the clamp torque varies or if the order in which you clamp them changes. It's the same reason vices have a fixed jaw and a sliding jaw. You want that consistent clamping surface, or else the clamps will be fighting against each other. Instead, use a fixed edge, like the edge of a pocket like we do, or the use of an aggressive fixed edge clamp insert, commonly known as talons or piranha strips. And finally, number five, don't use the wrong quantity. So earlier I mentioned not using the 1/2 inch width, but if you've got a small, delicate part, that's fine, since high clamping force isn't needed. Now, on the flip side, you don't want to use my recommended 3/4 inch size with a large steel part clamping on only one long edge. The formula I recommend is to multiply the width of the clamp by 3. That means you need a 3/4 inch wide clamp for every 2 1/4 inches of edge. Or if you're using a 1/2 inch wide clamp, you need one clamp for every 1.5 inches of part edge. And of course, if you're using a 1 inch wide clamp, obviously you need one clamp for every 3 inches on the part edge and so on. Now, after the rocker style clamps, the next mini clamp I would recommend are these aluminum channel clamps. Now, I recommend these because they also apply downward holding force when tightening. They come in a machinable version so you can match the shape of your part just like you would with soft jaws in a vise. Now, the downside of these clamps is they have much lower holding force than the rocker style clamps, but I would recommend them for second operation work because they don't tend to mar the machined faces of your part like the rocker clamps do. That's what makes them great for second operations. So here are a few don'ts when using these types. Number one, don't clamp using only the top edge. If you take a close look, the top edge of these clamps is not even supported, and cutting forces or clamping forces alone can easily compromise your work holding security. You want to sink your parts deep down into a pocket so that the point at which the wedge contacts the inside of the channel is in line with your part. This line is where the clamping force will be highest. Number two, as I mentioned with the other style clamps, don't put these in channels. Pockets with proper clearance is best. Also keep in mind to not create your pocket to the same width as the clamp, because these have a lot more throw and you might create a false clamping sense if you've expanded them to touch the edge of your pocket and not the face of your part. And finally, number three, use the right quantity. Keep in mind that these have much lower clamping force than rocker clamps. So my formula for these is to multiply the width of the clamp face by 2 to find out how many you need. This means 1 inch wide clamps is gonna only be sufficient for clamping on 2 inches of material. Now, let's talk about some other styles of clamps. And this might be my most controversial point, but here we go. Don't use other types of clamps. There, I said it. Now, why would I not recommend other styles? Well, let's break some of these down. Cam style clamps have always been popular and I see them often, but machining strategies have changed over the years. The old school machining strategy was to take the diameter of the cutter and go 50% axial and 50% radial engagement. This has been replaced with the superior high speed machining approach, which means maximum axial length of the entire flute and only 10 to 15% of radial engagement. This strategy greatly increases metal removal rates and extends cutter life significantly. However, the axial engagement causes cutting forces to want to pull up on the part rather than to shift it sideways. Now, cam style clamps don't apply downward pressure when tightening them. So this means that your part can be lifted up along with the body of the clamp. Now, you might not notice your part being pulled up, but it's too late when you catch it in inspection. Now, I've seen different versions of these clamps that use an eccentric countersunk head that does apply downward force, but the reason I don't recommend these is because it places all of the clamping force sideways on the thread of the fixture. Now, threads are really meant for axial loads, not radial, and you'll quickly deform your threads to where they're sloppy and unusable. No one likes sloppy threads. Now, there are a lot of other great clamps out there that I would approve of, like OK Vice, Dynaforce, and ID Expansion clamps, to name a few, but they're a lot more expensive, and you can often get away with the first two styles I mentioned earlier. Again, I'd approve of them, but don't use them if keeping down the cost of your fixture is a main concern. So if you want to design money-making fixtures, dig in with this playlist to the entire Pierson Fixture Friday series. And if you want to take your production to the next level with automation or lean manufacturing to streamline your business, subscribe where we cover all these topics in our other videos. So until next time, go innovate your production.